sipping pure J with the ill nana. Yeah, yeah, you off around. I had your loyalties and your joint. You're getting your royalties and your points. So what the deal is? For Foxy Brown make cake. Now we late finding that slide.
So next question.
Michelle, TPP Colorado, wants to know what your Valentine's Day mean to you.
What does Valentine's Day mean to me? I think that somebody loved the idea of love so much that they made love a holiday. Just a day to where, you know, people get caught up in their lives to where, you know, you may not be able to stop and have a romantic dinner, you know, as much as you may like to. I mean, people work, you know what I'm saying? You got kids, all kind of shit. So it's just like, I think it's like a reminder day. Like, hey, your fucking wife needs you to take her dinner. You know, you shouldn't forget things like that. And I'm not saying that people... It's okay to forget things like that, but, you know, the economy's bad, you working, you know, your spouse is working, like, my sister and her fiance, you know, my sister goes to work in the morning, she gets off,
bless you,
she gets off at 5, you know what I'm saying, by the time she get home, her fiance is going to work, you know, she goes in at 5, she don't get off until, you know, 5 in the morning, damn near, so, you know, they get about an hour in bed. You know, normally my sister sleep, and then they get up, my sister going back to work. You know what I'm saying? So it's just times like that where you don't get to see your partner as much as you want. You don't get to show them as much as you want because you're too busy working, making sure they have everything that they want and need. So, you know what I'm saying? I think it's a day that's just mandatory that you must. It's, you know, today is my, it's God, I gotta make it about my baby. Even though everything is about my baby, I have to make it about my baby. So, it's not just a love day. It's not like a, oh, I shouldn't be in the hype of everything else. You know, it's kind of like, I work hard. So if I can't stop working any other day because I got to pay this rent or these bills, today, baby, is about you. If any day.
Sabrina Stevenson, what would turn you on most that a woman could do for your Valentine's Day, your favorite?
What would turn me on most that a woman could do for me for Valentine's Day? No. Maybe nice candlelit home cooked dinner. You know, some candles. Maybe sex games, you know, some very long foreplay. It's a night of passion. Maybe feed each other some fruits, take each other a bath. I mean, hit every part of the house up. You know, I'm a lovemaker, so it doesn't take a lot to impress me. I'm not in it for, you know, gifts and, you know, all kind of shit. Where you gonna fall off this pillow? So, that doesn't really take long. Some sexy lingerie.
Toya is gonna be what's gonna be Toya. If you met your perfect lady, I mean true love of your life, but the timing was wrong for her own reasons, would you wait for her?
I would try to. If you love somebody, you try to wait. But you cannot stop your life for anybody. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I would try to wait, but if I can't, I can't. You know, if it's meant to be, it'll be.
So be a husband.
I think I want one more. I don't know if I want to have it. But I think I want one more. And then, you know, I don't know if I meet somebody that has kids, you know, that's always okay. I don't mind that. I love kids, so it doesn't matter to me.
Vanessa,
are you
kidding? What's your best Valentine's Day ever you've ever had?
Best Valentine's Day that I've ever had. I think it was probably a couple years ago. My ex-wife, I like went all the way out. She was gone. Sent her to a spa. I like decorated the house. I ordered like I don't know how many bouquets of roses. I mean, it straight up looked like brown sugar. For real. So, yeah, there was roses everywhere, balloons everywhere. I pulled, like, the dining room table into the living room and took all the couches, all the furniture out and set it right in front of the fireplace and lit the fireplace. That was real pretty. Got, like, these plates, you know, they were, like, heart-shaped plates and put some desserts on that. We got some chocolate-covered strawberries and I made steak and shrimp and salad. We had wine. I like covered the window with foil so it can be dark and all the candles could just set up. You know, I put some red lights on in the lamps and shit. Drew a bad rose petals, chocolates. I mean, I went in that day. So, yeah. She woke up to diamonds. She got in the car. There was diamonds in her seat. Step the game up, baby. Step the game up.
What's one of the most romantic things you've ever done for someone else or someone has done for you?
That was pretty much the most romantic thing that I've ever put together for myself. But, I mean, recently I did something, but I really don't want to get into it, but, yeah, when I proposed, I think that was pretty romantic.
Caution, pow pow. Are you intimidated by aggressive femmes? Most thugs don't like to feel vulnerable mentally or emotionally. Would you let go for the right one?
My last was an aggressive femme. And when I say aggressive, she was aggressive. And I loved it. So, I have no problem playing this and this alone. I'm not a stud, so that's probably why I'm okay with it and they're not. I don't really know where you're from or how we would go about that, so I can't really answer that. But if I could, I would.
Misha Sparkle wants to know, why do females stay in a relationship when they're not attracted to the spouse sexually? I know I'm late, but hey, I gave it a try.
Misha, why do people stay in relationships when they're not attracted to their spouse sexually? I don't know, because maybe they love them. I mean, just because there's a certain part missing in a relationship, I just feel like if you talk to that person and they love you enough, maybe it'll be something that they can change. You know, maybe they can change their, you know, their way of dressing, or, you know, maybe do some role playing or find something to make it interesting so that you can fill that void. I mean, the option of going and getting it somewhere else, which you don't do, somebody else will do. It's just not, it's ridiculous, but it's there. So I think that, you know, I'm just like that. If my baby wants a white bitch today, then it's time to bust out. You know, the white boy gear, you know, my baby wants a gangster, you know, it's just, you gotta make things interesting. You can't just not make things interesting. Hey, little girl, you see how she don't listen? Beauty? You see how beauty don't listen? But I know y'all see this collar. I know you see her blinged out, right? With the yellow gems, the yellow, the canaries.
Tamika Davis, I can't keep missing your ass, Houston, but I'm coming slowly. So what is the most romantic dinner you could have think to serve on someone on Valentine's Day?
Serve? I mean, it's not really about what I want to eat, it's what they want to eat. You know, there's aphrodisiacs and stuff, but not everybody loves aphrodisiacs. Nobody would be eating the oysters. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it's pretty much just whatever I cook. So whatever I cook is going to be good. But I'm a steak fan. I'm a shrimp fan. I'm a tilapia fan. You know what I'm saying? I'm a lasagna fan. Italian food fan. So I really don't think that it doesn't really matter. Whatever she wants, I'll make it. And if I can't make it, then we're going to go get it. So.
Rhonda Birdhouse wants to know, in the years that you have been an entertainer, what would you say was the biggest unforgettable moment?
The years of me being an entertainer, the most biggest and unforgettable moment? I can't really say I've had the biggest, most unforgettable moment. But I will say what matters to me the most is being able to interact with all of you. When I come to a new city and I get to meet people that I've never met before, but show me so much love on my pages and my walls and my YouTube videos, that's kind of like the highlight of my event. You know, a little bit of time that I'm on stage is cool, and I'm happy that you're getting what you want or seeing what you want to see. But, you know, me being able to give hugs and get kisses and, you know, see people's reactions and take pictures and, you know, maybe have a drink or, you know what I mean, want to jig together, whatever it is. You know, that's the fun part. Little girl, what are you doing? Excuse me, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am. What exactly are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? You're just waking him up. You're bothering me. You're interrupting my video. You're doing the fucking most. Again, you should be doing the bare minimum, and you're not going nowhere because you're not about to tear nothing up. So relax. Beauty. 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 I'm not talking to you. You say it's people. Oh, man, now they're both awake. Little girl. What's wrong with you? You show everybody your fat ass? Say hi, fatties. Say hi, Facebook.
Alana
Lindsay wants to know, if I fly all the way out there to see
you, will you go out on a date with
me? Yes.
And I still need to know
where
this
is. Yes. That's what
she made you?
Yes. I will go out on a date with you, Alana. Which I think she's in Cali. I think you're in Cali, and I'm going to be coming to Cali for my birthday. Me and King Kells are having a birthday party in L.A. in April on the 8th. So, yeah. Of course I will. I think he's so cute. Ow. Ow, you're hurting mommy. What is wrong with you?
Edwina, Miles wants to know, okay, I'm normally late, but my B-Day is a week after Valentine's Day. If you were my other half, how would you celebrate them with me?
I would get you something that you wanted really bad. I'd send you to a spa, probably get your nails done, your hair done, you know, have you right. Take you out to dinner. And if you wanted to go out after that, we can do that, or we can just stay on the plate all night. So, I guess we're done. Now, let me jump off this damn camera and take these badass dogs. Ow, you're hurting me. You're hurting me. Ow. You already busted my bird open. Ow.
Oh,
bless you. And make sure on the 18th, you're at Club Epic, not only to see me, DC, Kells, and to celebrate Flawless' anniversary. It is also Misha's birthday, so we're gonna be in there, we're gonna be getting it in. So make sure, it's just a lot of events that's gonna be going on that night. It's gonna be a big event, so just make sure that you're coming. Hey, your teeth are sharp. You're not little baby puppies no more. You're big with sharp teeth. Look at this. Can I bite you back? But yes, the 18th, Misha's birthday is going down. Flawless' Club, Houston, Texas, Club Epic. DC, Dallas, Pretty Pretty, King Carols, many more. So, let's do it up, okay? Spot it. Ow, you're hurting me. Okay, we're about to try to hurry up and upload this. It's going to take a little minute because it makes it a little longer than we expected. But I love you guys so much. And keep an eye out for me because we getting ready to do some big things. The calendars are coming. They will be ready by next month. Actually, we are next month, aren't we?
They'll be out this month.
I would say this month, give me about another week. It should be out and ready to go. Ready to rock and roll. So, yes, keep an eye out for that as well. Okay? See you guys soon. Love you. Say bye, guys. Look at her chewing on my motherfucking necklace. She's bad. Say bye. Say hi to your... Say hi to Beauty. Beauty. Say hi. Call me. Ouch.
Beauty. Hey, mama.
Oh, that's my curly. The girls like those. I need them. Ow. Bitches. Oh. Hey! Get my horseshoes! Where's my little boy? Where's my little girl? Where's my little boy? Where's my little girl? Where's my little... Little boy, little girl, little boy, little girl. Ow, my bird. You're hurting me, guys. Say bye to Facebook and Twitter and YouTube and everybody.
All right, there they go.
Call me.
Beauty. Come
here.
Beauty.
Come
on.
Okay. Beauty. Now, those ain't no dogs. I don't know what it is. That's a razor.